Michelle Bunker with Chevrolet, and I'm here to talk to you about the 2012 Chevrolet Volt, which is right behind me. So this is the Volt. It goes by typical 40 miles per average per charge. And how you charge this car is with a 110 charger, and every car comes with one. It looks like this. I tell people if you can plug in a hairdryer, you can plug in this. It's a simple 110 plug. You just need to make sure it's a standalone plug in your garage. And then this end goes into the side of the car over here, so let me show you that. So this simply goes in here like this, and then you would plug this into your garage, or if you're at a hotel or wherever you are, this is portable, you can take it with you. It costs roughly $1.50. So $1.50 to go 40 miles. On average, our customers go in 42 days without going to the gas station. So a little bit over once a month, they're going to the gas station. It is a lithium battery that's inside. It's a T-shape. That's why this car is four seats. So it runs up the middle of the vehicle and then ends in the back seats. Both seats fold down flat. I'm giving you a little bit more extra storage. Fit a bicycle, stroller, whatever you want in here. The car comes standard with an 8-year warranty for the battery, 3 years OnStar. It comes with Bluetooth, so you can talk to hands-free. It also has a thing called TiVo for radio, so if you get a phone call in the middle of your favorite radio program, you can record the radio and play it back so you don't miss anything. It has a full nav screen, AM/FM radio. The best thing about this car is really driving it. It's very quiet because it's all electric all the time. I really encourage people, there's a dealer demo program now that people can go up to their local dealer and take a test drive whenever they want. So the best thing for people who are really interested to go to the dealer, drive. No sales pitch, just to tell me you want to drive. The Volt is very quiet. An electric vehicle really doesn't make any noise when it's driving in pure electric mode, battery mode. So the engineers work with the National Deaf and Hard of Hearing Association to develop a chirp so you can let people know without having to sound the horn that you're close to them. It's on the end of the blinker, you just push in the button and it makes kind of a chirp, chirp, chirp noise to give people the signal that you're there.
You also mentioned there were some different drive modes.
Yep, there's three drive modes for customers. There's normal, sport, and mountain. Normal is normal. Sport gives you a little bit more pep. It gives the same torque curve, but gets there faster.
generation Camry or Corolla or whatever, kind of go, well, let me look at something different. Maybe I'll just think about something else. It was around that time that these guys started coming out with some pretty cool looking cars, as well as Ford and General Motors and others. So it's really kind of taken the shine, if you will, off of what were the old standards, Camry and Ford and RAV4 and stuff like that. They've introduced a car here today called the Azera. I'm not going to pass judgment. I'd like to hear what you guys think. Production. I toured the facility that makes the Sonata and the Elantra about 6 or 7 months ago. And as soon as they make it, it's sold. But they can only make 300,000 a year at that facility. That's all they've got. So you're not going to see them like become market dominators because they can't make enough. It's a good problem to have. They don't have to put incentives on it. They can sell them as close to MSRP as possible. But it's, you know, it's obviously for us, it makes it